But that's what I'm saying. What he said, he's gonna be saying some things with you. Amen. And I'm looking at a time between 2:32 and 2:30 a.m. in the morning. Amen. The sleeper's gonna deal with it. God is gonna begin to shake you. Amen. Amen. But what's gonna do a lot of times in the speech, when we get up and we didn't say it, we just want to be the grab our word. Amen. Got to do what Samuel did. When Samuel learned from Eli what to do, we got to get to a point, amen, because we're quick to open up and talk to God. Amen. But what he's saying is this here. He said, it's time for the saints of God to say, speak, Lord, thy servant is listening. Speak, Lord. Say, speak, Lord, thy servant is listening. But what has to happen is that we have to sit there with God with a pen and paper, amen? And let God begin to instruct us. Because I look at this thing with Noah. He gave Noah the exact direction.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Yes. Amen? He gave him the exact dimensions, amen, of everything. He told him how many animals to take in. He told him how many clean and unclean to take in. He said, two of them, all of them. He said, take them by two. All the clean, I said, make them by seven. All the men. Amen. He has to follow the divine specification that he gave. That's what he did. He said, that's what we have to do today. Follow the blueprint, amen. Follow the blueprint. Follow the map. Follow the plan that God has given you, amen. Don't look at nobody else's stuff, amen. A lot of times look at different ideas. You got the same chairs I got. I just bought them. Ain't no, you had this chair. This is the same blood on ministry, amen.
Amen.
This is the same. I mean, the royalty. That's why I went this program, amen. Purple and gold, amen. That, I'm saying, that's deity, amen. And that's royalty. Honestly. I like these chairs, but I like chairs in my pulpit. I don't like to say mine at times. I don't like to say that bothers me just being said mine. Amen. I just mean, amen. I like the chairs. I like them. But the thing about what happened, a lot of times we look at what other people have, and we want to now take what they got.
Wow.
Paul said this. He said, I followed the commandments and to the T. But when he told me not to not cut, I died. That's what Paul says. Don't covet somebody else's vision.
That's the word.
Amen. That's the word. God has something special just for you.
Amen.
Has something special for you. I'm talking about, hold on. That does not really help, don't
worry.
Amen. But just know what I'm saying. If we're going to build the kingdom of God, amen, and our church, he said, building the kingdom of God by the word of God. That's by whatever God speaks. That's what we build the kingdom of God on. And the only way that we're going to build this kingdom is that we abide in Christ and Christ abide in us.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
There's no other way that we as a people, amen, as a body, think about it. As the body can't do nothing that the head don't tell it to do.
Right.
But so often the body is functioning without receiving a message from the head. Now y'all see them people that. Christ is the head.
Yes.
He's the head. We're the body.
Yes.
So the body itself must wait on the command from the head that go forth and carry out the command of the head. That's what we must do as a body of believers. That's what we must do. That's what we must do. You see, God has given me a vision a while back. I was never a strong proponent of or believer of denominations. I saw it early on, even before I asked my call, that it was nothing but a vision. It was keeping the body separate. Now watch this, this is man instituted way of operating. God did not give no denomination.
Amen.
He didn't. He said, partners, right, I'll be in my church. And the Holy Spirit here is now the guide for us because he's a messenger from Christ.
That's right.
The Spirit of Christ that's in us, he's the one that dictates what we do.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen?
But the thing is now is that we allow denominationalism in there, and because you may not worship the way I worship, you may not preach the way I preach, you may not have that joy the way I work. No. You may not have the doctrine or the, whatever. No, it ain't about that then.
That's right.
It's the anointing of God.
That's it.
It's the anointing of God. So I see what God is doing right now for me. And I know that's why Bishop Bowe came along to indict the lie that was already in me. And that's what he had me doing right now. Is to get other brothers to come together, because we can't look at different denominations, we can't look at different colors, we can't look at this thing here. We got to look at the spirit.
That's right.
And see what spirit that person, amen? And a lot of times they may not have it, but God, he will surely break that one more down when he begins to see what God the body wants to do. Amen?
Amen.
But I'm telling you right now, what he's doing there in Belgrade right now, I know there's nothing but God bringing all these churches together to have this revival that's happening down there. And I pray that you're able to come down and actually take part in it. I look at you, if you can't pray, come but Saturday night. That's the night that, Lord Jesus, I told us, give me that night. I have a great man of God that is coming from Virginia that's going to bring a power pack with it. Amen. He's going to bring over that night there's where Grace Fellowship along with Good Shepherd and First Baptist. Amen. I'm waiting on Pastor Carol as well, but that's the night that we're going to be hosting everything. Amen. We do have a mass choir. That's going to be it. If you have anyone that's, if you want to come down and take part, if you want to sing, they can make the rehearsal, but make sure they get the song and they can actually know what's transpiring. Amen. But I'd love you to come down and take part.
Amen.
That is June the 8th through the 11th. The 11th, the day where the Lord's going to allow me to just go forth with their vision and let them know what the true purpose of things is, conclusion of it. Amen.
Amen.
I just thank God, man of God.
Amen.
I thank God. I pray that the word comes with the fact that can help you out. I pray that you've been empowered spiritually.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
I pray that you've been enlightened and encouraged. Amen.
Amen.
And
amen.
That answer, I will look for another opportunity. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To just break
amen.
We're both there to make great to get down to send your bill, man.
Amen.
God bless you. Come on, Pastor. You can go ahead and thank you. Isn't he wonderful?